Have you post-processed your work and as you're doing that, you're realizing everything's too tight. I need some more space in my photograph. And you're flustered and you're saying, oh, this is not what I wanted. Well, I'm going to teach you how to add canvas to your photograph. I'm Janice Sullivan from Sullivan J Photography, and this is the place where we chat about macro and landscape photography, post-processing, equipment, behind the scenes, you name it, and we will chat about it. So Debbie was frustrated because she wanted to add a little bit more to her image. And I get that because I do that all the time. It gets too tight, or I start post-processing. I wish I had a little bit more here or there. So we're going to go into Photoshop right now, and I'm going to share with you how to add canvas to your work. I'm going to show you two examples. One, which is super easy like this one, and another example, which is a little bit harder because there's a lot more going on. So let's do the easy one first. This is a huge pano that I'm working on and I've just started it. So over here to the right, what I always do is make a copy of the layer. Control for PC, Command for Mac, J to make a copy. I like to make a copy because I always do the before and after. So here at the top, you could see that I hardly have any sky left here at the very top. So I need to add more. It's too crunched up. What I'm going to do is add canvas. So we're going to go here to image, canvas size. I need more in the sky. So what I'm going to do is push the bottom down here and only add canvas. The arrows are telling me that the canvas is going to go straight up. So you could push these buttons and tell the canvas how you want to add or even subtract pixels. But most of the time we're adding pixels. So I want to do the top. I have pixels 5100. I'll add 5120. Let's see what that looks like. And I will say okay. Let's go a little bit more. I'm gonna add a little more. This is such a large file that I'm chopping the video so you don't have to sit here and wait. Okay, that looks good. I brought it down so you can actually see what's going on here. Now Photoshop can take all the pixels that's next to this and merge it into the area that has no information. So the easiest way to do this, because there's just that easy strip, is to go over here and click on Magic Wand. And here's your wand, and we're just gonna click on the area that has no pixel information, and there's marching ants, you can see the marching ants. The next thing we're gonna do is go to Edit, Fill. Sometimes it's foreground, background, color, but we want Content Aware, which takes all the information that's around this strip and it's going to work its magic. And I'm going to push OK. You don't need to worry about all this blend modes and all that stuff. Just push OK. And voila, I have a sky. It's so awesome. So now I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the selection. So I'm going to do the Control or Command D to deselect. And to tell you the truth, I want more. I want more. There's no way. So I'm going to do this really quick. So here's the before with hardly any sky. And here is the after with sky. That's the easiest way to do this. That's a super easy way to do it. But most of the time, that's not going to happen that way. So let's go ahead and go into the second one. So here's a little bit more challenging. This image I'm just starting to work on. And I see that it's just too tight over here to the right and maybe down below. I'm not sure yet. So since I've started post-processing, now I have issues. Either I got to go back or I add a merge visible. So I'll have to make a stamp or I need to make a copy of everything so it has the pixels in order to add the canvas. What I'll do is I'll go to the layer that I've changed up and I will make a copy of everything below it because I need those pixels. That's why I say that if you feel like you need Canvas, it's so good just to do it right straight from the beginning. You know, sometimes you don't see it till later and you've done a lot of post-processing. What you'll do is on your keyboard, hit Control, the Alt Option key, and Merge Visible. Now it has made a copy of everything down below it. Now we can add the canvas. So we'll go to Image, Canvas Size. So if you click Relative and you want everything to move around, say if I want, we work in pixels a lot. So let's say if I want to add 300 pixels, I'll push OK. And now I have 300 pixels. So we're going to go to Image, Canvas Size. Another way that you can change it, so we'll go ahead and only add the right. So I want the arrows to go to the right. Now, if I wanted this inches, you could see that you have all of these things that you can change to whatever you're used to working with. Again, I'm used to pixels, so I'm going to go to pixels. Now, I'm telling this right now that I want this image to be a little bit more on the right side. Now, here is the actual pixels, but if you just say relative on what you want, well, let's say that I want 200 pixels instead of calculating exactly what I want. Now, sometimes you may want it to a certain pixel width and you want to type it all in. Another way of doing it is just saying I want about 200 more pixels going to the right, and boom, there is my pixels that I've just added. So here I'm going, and this is the background. It's easy. See how it says the background? This white right here is the background. So if I changed the background to black, it would be black. But it's easier to make sure that it's white, because once you select the white area here, now we have the white pixels that we've just made. Now, if you have a very light image, what I would do is I would select the black pixels and maybe merge that. But I've never had to do that. I've always done the white. It's pretty much worked about 99%. To edit, fill, you'll get a pop-up, and I'm going to fill with Content Aware here. And Photoshop is pretty good. So now what I'm going to do is the Control Command D to deselect. And now what you really do need to do is get up close, because even though Photoshop is pretty good with this, you may have lines because there's so many different colors going on. So I would get up, I'm at 200 now, but I would get up and just really look. You could see this is a merged image that I'm going to clean up. So you see all this mess over here, just a little tidbit. But anyways, you'll see the good one after I'm done with it. So this, I'm just going to kind of go in where I've, you can see here, the before and the after. I'm just clicking on the eye. And I'm just going to make sure that there's no lines, because sometimes when you add Content Aware, you'll see like a little line. So let's see how good Photoshop did. It even did good here. There we go. And sometimes if it's really repetitious on an area that you have, then I would clean it up with clone stamping or whatever. It's perfect just to add a little bit more canvas to your work if it's real tight like that. We've got an awesome image with extra canvas. See, adding canvas wasn't too bad. And you know that when you have questions, please ask down below. So if you'd like to check out more information on Photoshop, then click here. And remember that 1,000 words does make a difference. Have a great day. Cheers.